knows a lot about all kinds of stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
For the past few tutorials, we have been studying a few different types of differential equations and how to solve them. Separable, linear, and exact are the three main classes of first-order differential equations, but there are a few more you should be aware of. Firstly, we need to define a homogeneous function. We say that a function f of two arguments a and b is homogeneous if scaling the arguments by some parameter t results in the value of f being scaled by some exponent of the parameter. Symbolically, f is homogeneous if f of t a t b is equal to t to the n times f of a b, where n is a constant known as the order of f. For example, the function given by f of a b equals a squared plus a times b is homogeneous, because if we multiply each argument by t, we get t squared a squared plus t squared a b. Since we can factor out t squared and be left with the original function a squared plus ab, this satisfies the definition of a homogeneous function, and its order is equal to 2. The type of differential equation we'll now learn to solve is any dE that can be written in the form f of xy dx equals g of xy dy, where f and g are both homogeneous functions of the same order. We call this a homogeneous differential equation. We encountered this word homogeneous before in the first tutorial on differential equations, where it meant any linear dE without terms with only the independent variable or constants. So is there any connection? It turns out that non-linear dEs can be homogeneous too. They just don't fit the same nice pattern as the linear ones, so now we need to use this broader definition. To solve a homogeneous differential equation, linear or not, we can use a neat trick. Using a special substitution, y equals u times x, or equivalently, u equals y divided by x, we can change the dependent variable in our dE from y to u. In fact, if we see a differential equation of the form dy dx equals some function of the fraction y over x, then we can be sure that this is homogeneous. Using this substitution will always result in a separable dE, which we already know how to solve, and then we can undo the substitution to get our solution. This concept of a substitution will come up again and again in solving dEs, so it's important to get familiar with how to use them. Here's an example. Let's solve the differential equation dy dx equals x squared plus y squared all over x times y. This might look simple, but it's actually not separable, nor linear, nor exact, so we need to try something else. This is, of course, a homogeneous differential equation in disguise, and we now know two ways to show it. Firstly, if we cross-multiply everything out, we can identify the two functions x squared plus y squared and x times y, and it's easy to show that these are both second-order homogeneous functions, so our definition of a homogeneous differential equation is met. Alternatively, if we start from our original dE and just do a little algebra, we notice that we end up with an expression that's purely in terms of the fraction y over x. This is the telltale sign of a homogeneous dE. So the way to solve it is to use the homogeneous substitution y equals ux, where u is a function of x, to transform our dE from one where the dependent variable is y into one where the dependent variable is u. In order to eliminate y from our dE, we need expressions for both the y and dy dx terms that appear in our dE. We know y in terms of u, because that's our substitution, y equals ux. But how can we get dy dx in terms of u? If we differentiate both sides of our substitution, y equals ux, with respect to x, using the product rule, recalling that u is a function of x, we get dy dx equals x times du dx plus u. Now that we have found both y and dy dx in terms of u, we need to put these into our original dE. On the left side of our dE, we replace dy dx with x du dx plus u. On the right side of our dE, we replace all the y terms with ux. Let's expand, cancel the x squared terms, cancel the u terms, and isolate du dx. Notice that this is a separable differential equation with u as the dependent variable instead of y. We already know that to solve a separable dE, we separate the variables and integrate both sides. Doing this for our dE gives 1 half u squared equals log of x plus c, where c is an arbitrary constant. Notice that here we can absorb the constant c into the logarithm, replacing it with a new constant k, where k equals e to the c. From this, we get the implicit solution for u in terms of x as u squared equals 2 log kx. The last thing to do is undo the substitution y equals ux to change the solution variable from u back to y. So we replace u with y over x in our implicit solution to get y squared equals 2x squared log kx, which is the general solution to our dE. There's just one more type of differential equation to look at. Whereas homogeneous DEs can be reduced to separable DEs using a substitution, there's also a type of DE that can be reduced to a linear DE using another substitution, and that's the Bernoulli differential equation. A Bernoulli DE is any that can be written in the form dy dx plus y times p of x equals y to the nth power times q of x, where p and q are functions and n is a constant. You can see that this sort of looks like a linear DE, but with that extra multiple of y to the n on the right side, which makes it nonlinear. The appropriate substitution for Bernoulli DEs is to let u equal y to the 1 minus n, which we'll show with an example. Suppose we want to solve the dE dy dx plus x to the fifth y equals x to the fifth y to the seventh. We can immediately see that this is a Bernoulli dE with functions p and q of x both being equal to x to the fifth, where the nonlinear term has n equals 7. The correct substitution that we need to make will therefore be u equals y to the 1 minus n, which is y to the negative 6. We can rearrange this for y to get y equals u to the negative 1 over 6. Before we can use this substitution in our dE, we need to express dy dx in terms of u, which we can do by differentiating both sides of this substitution with respect to x. Using the power rule and the chain rule, we will get dy dx equals negative 1 sixth times u to the negative 7 sixths times du dx. Now that we have expressions for both y and dy dx, we can put them into our dE to eliminate y, and we get this new differential equation here. This looks complicated, but we are guaranteed that this must simplify to a linear dE, so let's simplify it by dividing both sides by the coefficient of du dx, which is equivalent to multiplying both sides by negative 6u to the 7 sixths, and we find that we do indeed get a simple linear dE. Since we already know how to solve this linear dE using the integrating factor method, we will jump to its solution, which is u equals 1 plus k times e to the x to the sixth, where k is an arbitrary constant. All that's left to do is undo our substitution to get y instead of u, so we get the general solution to our dE as y equals 1 plus k times e to the x to the sixth, all to the negative 1 sixth. We've now covered a total of 5 different classes of first-order differential equations, and you might be thinking, how am I supposed to identify what type of differential equation I'm being asked to solve? The answer is nothing but practice. So here's some good practice testing everything you've learned so far.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.